Alright, I climbed back to this spot exactly. And the only thing I really needed to do different was climb up further and continue along this ledge. And that's the fire over there. Now I just need to make this jump. Alright. Let's go and save real quick here. Also, apparently we have enough for another weapons upgrade. Sure, let's do the full auto shotgun. What can we get it? An extended magazine. Is that the same as for the break action shotgun? No, that's the forced ejector mod. More reload speed. I mean, I'm gonna use the full auto more so, I think. And an extended magazine seems like a good idea for that one. Larger magazine allows more shots to be fired before the need to reload. Apply to all full auto shotguns. Okay. So, wait, where do we want to go now? There is one more tomb left. And I think it's probably easier to fast travel this, actually. That would be this one. Even though loading times are a bitch. So one more tomb and we'll have 100%ed this area, I think. And also all of the game, all of the levels we've encountered so far. So we're then good to continue on and finish the story. So this tomb is just right across from here. Optional challenge tomb nearby. You don't say. Oh god. Into the muck. What do we have here? Some loot. Some wood and some ore. Is there something here? Would you like a survival cache or so? No? Okay. Optional challenge tomb. Oh god, I'm gonna slide, huh? Okay. So, climbing that wall will likely just get me back out, right? Okay. No. Shotgun doesn't help here. Before I climb that rope, I wanna see if there's anything in this water here, though. No. Okay. Press Leah to grab rope. What's this? Looks like a little green temple or something. A Greek temple, I mean. Okay.
Some kind of burial chamber.
Indeed. An artifact.
A basket made of silver. Certainly meant to be decorative, but someone's been using it to carry grain.
Hmm. That's a lot of skulls. Can't scramble up the skulls, so what is this for then? Was it just for the one artifact? Oh no. Gotta go this way, I guess.
Magnificent.
Catacomb of Sacred Waters. Just doing this for the save. Right, so there's a rope spool here. There's also a document.
Someone broke into this place in the dead of night. They filled their pockets with coin, turned over urns of oil and wine, and saw fit to show disrespect to all that are interred here. It shreds my heart to think that one of our own could be so callous as to desecrate this place, all for a momentary earthly gain. We must find a way to keep this place safe, even from our own brothers.
Thieves among us. Okay.
I can use the other spool to get the raft closer to the island.
What raft? Yeah, also, I mean, if I jump in, I'll probably just be flushed. Down there, or will I? There's a raft. Or rather a boat. Can I just pull it here? Okay. What will this do? Well, this is not gonna do anything. I'll probably need to get it over here, right? If I even can against the current. Why doesn't she just keep pulling? And let's go of it, like, after every pull. It's working, though. So I guess I can get on it. Right. Now. That should get me over there. What's this? No, another dock. Okay.
We may be far from our home, but that does not make us barbarians. When our loved ones pass on, as far too many have this season, we treat them with respect. When we did not yet have a vineyard to produce wine, we washed the dead with lake water. When we lacked the looms to spin the death shroud, we wrapped our departed in skins and hides. We carried few coins with us. But now we forge our own, so that our blessed dead can pay passage to the next world. I only wish that the price was not so high.
A journal from the head priest. They prepared bodies for burial in these chambers. Also, that's all documents in the geothermal valley, isn't it? Where's documents? Yeah, 33 out of 33. Just missing one relic. This tomb and the mission associated with it, and two survival caches. Then we'll have 100% of it.
Maybe there's another raft nearby.
Another raft. Right, so I can go back here with the spool. Also, I'm just thinking whether this is like physically possible, right? Because this spool is powered by a wheel, which is in turn powered by the current. So could this then be used to move a raft or a boat to travel in the opposite direction? I mean, I guess not, right? Because that would be, that would mean that you had found a contraption that can create an infinite energy. Or is that true? Probably not. Don't think I'm making sense right now. Right, so there's the last artifact, which, I mean, can I shoot at this? I can. Oh, there is another raft. Well, look at that. Why don't you? Oh god, am I just dead now? I'm dead now. Am I not? Yeah. Alright. We did just have the campfire. So yeah, I suspected that's what happens when you... fall into the water. I don't know, why would I need a second raft though? Why can't I just use the other one? Pick up bottles, cans, and other objects to make deadly weapons. Yes, yes. So, document one.
Someone.
Oh, also we got another skill point here.
I can use the other spool to get the raft closer to the island.
Right. Oh no, wait, why didn't I just do it the easy way and connected these two? Right. Now. Oh god. Okay. Ah. Okay, okay. I'm messing up now. Oh, this is gonna be fun in score attack. Not. Well, thankfully the optional challenge tomb score attack levels aren't that long.
Someone broke into this.
Right. So that's good to know that. I mean, that's why I need the second raft also, right? Just that these things don't hold for very long. Okay, we need to get closer to this. Get this over here. Then I need to wait for this to move into the right position, though, before I can jump. Ooh, there was some inertia going on there, I think. As portal formulates it, speedy thing goes in, speedy thing comes out. So there is another raft. Let's get that one out. Also, Oh, this is already where the...
That raft has a crank on it.
Manuscript is... Oh, that one has a crank on it. That's useful. I guess. What? Where's it going? Even. Come over here, raft. That's not a good angle. Right. So do I die if it does this? I hope not. Oh, I do. Alright, so I do need to time these as well. Well, bear with me. These are a bit trial and error. These tombs until you know exactly what you need to be doing. Well, it does make sense, I guess. Because I guess being... I guess hitting the rocks on the raft will... shake it quite badly and send Lara off balance, although she's usually pretty good at keeping balance. I'm just saying. Right, so first step of the way.
Someone broke into this.
Oh god. Right. I still don't understand why I can't just use this one, though. Oh, dead inertia. Huh.
Coins. We may be
coins. I want them. Oh, how many coins do I have now, by the way? 95. Still need like 40 more. It's gonna be rough. Okay. So can't I just get this raft over here and then ride it to over there? No, I guess not, because if I do this and then fasten it to the other one, I guess the rope's gonna be too long and it's gonna pull me into the rocks again, huh? And so if I do this, I'll have to jump on, fasten it to the other one, and then start doing this immediately to be able to get back there. And the rope will snap any second, I'm sure of it. Alright, that's how that works. Okay. Cool. Well, that's all. Alright.
Interesting. Did they embalm their dead?
The map? Some loot. The last artifact of the geothermal valley.
A golden chalice fit for a king. Or a prophet. It was made here in Kitezh.
Valuable stuff. Some mushrooms. And let's see what ability we get. Anatomical knowledge. Since the location of animal hearts when using survival instincts, 10,000 credits. Or aiming at prey. Shots into animal hearts inflict massive damage. Animals with thick hide, bears and large cats, are immune to hard shots. Why does it show a cat then, though? Mm-hmm. Tomb complete. Now, I am a bit worried as to why that side quest is still isn't completed, because I did complete 9 tombs, I think. I mean, right? Let's just have a look. So I've completed 4 tombs here. And the other ones are in the Soviet installation, I think. No, that's 3. Okay, so we got 7. And where's the other one? Well, let's do this from the start. So this one doesn't have any tombs. Syria. The mountain peak doesn't have any tombs. Siberian wilderness doesn't have one. Right, there was one in the glacial cavern. 3 here, so that's 4. Oh, we didn't complete the challenge in the research base as well. I need to go back to do that then. Might even do that in this video. So that was blowing up these trucks, but also doesn't have a tomb. Abandoned Mines doesn't have a tomb. The Acropolis doesn't have a tomb. And the Flooded Archives don't have a tomb. Alright, so there's one more to come, I guess. These are 4, which makes it a total of 8. Alright, that makes sense, actually. So I guess there's one more in Kitezh. Which means we'll have to return to this lady with that quest afterwards. Also, this quest gives us coins, right? So that might be enough to do it, though. And we're missing 2 survival caches. That's not a lot. Okay. So I guess this is our way out. Where we couldn't have destroyed this from the other side, that's kinda disappointing. Or I guess we could have, but it'll lead us to somewhere where we can just like drop down to the
should be a way to get across.
Yeah.
Perhaps I could use a rope.
I might even have noticed that without your help, Lara. Oh, that's okay. It's just going back there. Okay. Wait, do I want to go back to the fire? No, that means I'll have to do all this again to get back here. Well, then. Okay. No jumping, just pressing forward. Or, I mean, I could go back to the campfire and then fast travel out. But, eh. Right, so where are the last survival caches? Wait, did I see something flash over here? No. Back to the geothermal valley. Love how our boots sound soggy. Squirrel swill. Right, we did get a skill point. Cool. So we've mastered Survivor and Brawler. 20 out of 20, yeah. No, there's just Hunter left. Arrow retrieval and still no. Sure. Master of the land. And now I'm going to put on something warm. Warmer. And we'll fast travel into the... No, not into the Greek Fire Depot. To the research base. And where is that last truck? I'm pretty sure I was pretty thorough here. I don't know if there's one around this base camp though. Well, I think I'll travel here first. Okay. That doesn't seem to be like there's a lot of trucks here. Wait, this is literally where that level ended, right? Because we... Or maybe not, because we found Jonah. And there was a big shootout here as well. I think not so much, not so many enemies go in now though. But yeah, doesn't seem like there's barrels we can destroy here. And this is where that level ended, I guess. So we gotta go back. Or, oh, maybe it's this one. I mean, it is a barrel we can destroy. Oh god. That didn't pertain to the challenge though, apparently. What mate? Where's the way back? Oh, this way. That's easy to miss. Should have another look here, I guess. Oh look, didn't I do this, or is it just... Has it just respawned? Yeah, I guess this is as far as I can go. So the truck must have been in that other area then. Yeehaw. I thought I was so thorough in this. We can go back to the quest giver, because she does give us coins for every tomb that we clear, not just upon completing the quest. And maybe then we'll have enough to actually buy that last item on the on sale in the supply shack. So what, we're here now. Alright, let's look this way first. Alright, yeah, I need to dive. Alright, there's a couple of trucks here. But I think I blew one up in this area already. This one, right? Yeah. And this one doesn't have any... It does have some XP, but it doesn't have any... gas tanks. I mean, maybe I need to blow up a gas tank that isn't on a truck, just because all previous ones have been on a truck. Doesn't mean the last one has to, I guess. But yeah, there's none here. I mean... Are there any... further along? I don't know. Also, these steps sound slightly weird. Let's go check this way. Here, running engine. Not that that tells us. I mean. Oh no, this one has blown up. And the engine is still running somehow. Alright, these aren't it, obviously. Or, I mean, that's the second blown up truck. The third one was... No, it wasn't this one, actually. This one is just a crash truck after the bridge collapsed. So the third one was back here. Yeah, searching for these challenge locations can be a bit of a pain. Can it not? No, that's not it. I'm liking the lighting though. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Lighting so pretty. That was the one that's up here though. So... Another thing. Right. Some wood. So that was the first one, right? That was the second one. These were the third ones. I mean, they're even on my map, for Christ's sake. I mean, they're clearly visible on the map, the trucks. One's here. Second group is here, third group is here. Where would the fourth one be? It's not, I mean, is that one? Maybe? Will you just stop? Thanks. Oh, I just died, I guess. Alright, I think I'm gonna look this up. You got me. Four fuel tanks, yes. Right. Let's look at the map here. That's down there, yes. Next fuel tank is to the right of the frozen pond. The final tank is toward the end of the map, but cannot be reached if you use the campfire to fast travel to that side of the map. You must run through the region in order to access this last fuel tank. What does that mean? Do I have to come from this way then, I guess? I mean, I hope it's still reachable, otherwise that'd be sucky. If I couldn't 100% the game. Unless I do it like on the first instance of getting there. Also, how do I get up to the research base again? And why do I keep talking like this? There it is. There's the set of stairs. Well, I mean, at least we get to see the level at this beautiful lighting. Wait, what? How did this go? Yeah, knock him over. I don't remember. Did I climb through one of these windows? How did that work? Oh, okay. There's a ladder here. And yeah, this activated the story sequence. This is the correct way, yes. Yeehaw. I'm not there yet, no. Hmm. You're just way too good at this, Lara. Right. I guess now I'm in the right spot. And the tank is... Now the image doesn't load in the browser. Fuck you, image. There. Wait, what? Oh, did I already go too far? If so, then fuck you. I think I did. Oh! Well. How do I even get anywhere now? I guess I... Yeah, I'll have to drop down and... And fast travel again. Alright, I messed it up, guys. That's trouble. So yeah, don't go for the last zip line. Yeah, I'm gonna end this video after this, I think, and just continue with the story for now. Pretty much done already. Anyways. Alright, at least I know where to go now. Lara just likes the zipline action, really. That's why she wants to do it all again. Well, I mean, this is good training for the for when I eventually have to do the score attack thing, right? Which way was it? Is this correct? Pow, pa pow. Now I can even see the tank from here. Can I shoot it from here? Probably not. So I have to do one more zip line. Or two. But this is it, don't do this one. Okay. Yeah, this is easy. Yes. I get it. Ha! 2000 credits earned, challenge accepted. And completed. Okay, here we go. Let's just go back to the campfire. And I'll sit down. Haven't got anything to spend. And yeah, I'm just gonna go back to this base camp now and then continue with the main story. So thanks for watching this. These two bonus videos, I guess. And See you back after I fast travel. Gonna cut out the loading time. Bye-bye.